saying forgiveness is the key. Forgiveness is the key. Forgiveness is the key to eternity. You know, eternal what? Love and life. Okay. All this charities.
But forgiveness does. I mean, forgiveness is always a healer, you know?
It is a healer. It's healed. It's healing him.
You know, we're healing Reggie right now somewhat, too. We're helping him heal, I think.
Reggie says he loves his sister. He wants his sister to know that. He wants his mother to know it. And his father. But for some reason, I'm getting the idea that his father may have passed on already. You know, but I don't see his father.
I think I do. But I think...
Grayish tint to his beard or something.
Got like an older black guy. Yeah. Oh, maybe dark skin.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's in the same dimension.
Well, we'll find out.
We'll figure out in a minute.
But he loves his father, you know. Please don't cry over me anymore, is what he keeps saying. But I want to say it's okay to cry, you know.
It is okay to cry. Let me step in here. Look, we want to, Meka and your mom, whoever your family is watching this, it's okay to cry. But realize that spirits, when they cross over, that they feel everything you feel when you're thinking about them instantly. Don't even worry about it. They feel it instantly. Please excuse the phone's ringing. You know, and that when you're crying over Reggie, that's all right, I'll keep talking. When you cry over him, I'll keep it. Excuse me. I'm sorry for that. My apologies. But look, when you cry over him, you know, you're hurting him. You know, you hurt him too. And that's one of the things that we fail to understand, that there is no death. You know, we've forgotten here that we don't die ever. We've never been born. We never die. We never will die. You know, somebody might have shot Reggie, and then put his physical body out of commission irreparably. But yet, the soul can never be chopped up in any pieces. The soul can never be cut to pieces by any weapon. Water cannot wither it. You know, the wind does not burn the soul. You know, with wind burn, it can't be withered, can't be cut, can't be destroyed. And his soul is eternal, as well as yours. I just want to say that. Lord Krishna wanted me to say that. I quoted from the Bhagavad Gita, by the way. You might want to look into that book. Okay.
I apologize for having to get up and worry about worldly things.
And I apologize for him there, too. Let's continue. My apologies to you, Reggie.
But I think that's the message he wanted to get across, is a cross, you know. That he just loves his sister and his mother, and he wants them not to grieve over him as much. You know, it's affecting him. Now, the process of grieving is important. I understand this, you know, and that's what's got to be done. Maybe get the grieving out first.
Yeah.
And then let the happiness begin.
Yeah, because you get to the point, Jeremy and I, let me put this out, like, we're at this point in spiritual evolution. Like, you know, when we hear people die, you know, we dance for joy. You know what I'm saying? We're smiling and happy.
It's different because they're going on to a better place.
And we know it, we see it, we deal with it every day. You know, there's nothing to be upset about. And then, of course, there's nothing wrong with being in forgetfulness right now. That's what you guys are in still. When you wake up, the happiness will come. I feel Reggie is dropping. Do you drop in on them? I know that, right?
I'm there with them, yeah.
Yeah. You know, but you get frustrated because they can't feel you, right?
Right.
You know, and I can see how frustrating it is for Mike, too. This is another subject, but he was having the same frustration, you know, that they don't see you. And they can't feel the love that you're trying to send, you know. But we're making our best effort here, Reggie. You know, this is going to go up today. And
just tell my sister I love her, and I look at a picture of her all the time with a white background.
Yeah, do that. Yeah, I was going to say, put some things through to make it incontrovertibly clear that it's you. Okay, stuff that there's no way, I don't want there to be any doubt in her mind. Okay, Reggie?
Just something, showing me something about a white sweater in the picture with a white background and her that he keeps in his mind at all times. Yeah, he looks at her, he loves her, you know, he misses her. That's all.
Okay, she'll get that message, won't she, Reggie? She'll understand that.
She will.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Look, brother, I hope we did the, I mean, did we do all right for you, man? I have to ask, keeping it real enough, Reggie? We're trying to keep it real with you. Yeah?
He says it's his fault in a lot of ways because he doesn't know what to say either. He's quiet. I'm quiet,
okay.
Too.
It's okay, brother.
I'm quiet. Jeremy's quiet.
Don't worry. It's okay. It's okay, man. No need to feel bad about it. Don't feel bad. You know,
is correct, and Christmas is correct.
You know, don't feel bad about it, Reggie. You know, like you went out in a violent way, man. It looks like you live violently, live by the sword, die by the sword. It's positive in my mind. Mm-hmm. You know? And
Christmas says that is yes, yes.
And very true. You know, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. And, but it's okay. You're not in some hell. Fake, human made up hell, made up for control over humans.
No, not at all.
You're fine. And you have the best. I want to say Meka too, that he has the best of guidance. You know, like we said it before, he has Lord Buddha, Lord Christ, and Lord Krishna, all with him. They're helping him as we speak. Correct.
Correct.
And they will be with him all the time. They're taking care of him. You know, they're his friends now. You know, they're there to show compassion and love and to heal him. So, I just wanted you to know that. And to Reggie's mother, too. And same thing, you know. But we're going to close this off for here. Reggie has gotten this message out. I feel it's a relief coming. It's like a relief feeling watching.
Yeah.
It helped him to speak those words, correct?
He's a lot less antsy on the other side, if I could say. He was more kind of fighting himself because he wanted to talk.
So bad.
Let him talk. So
yeah,
we did the best we could. I think he feels better. Do you feel better, Reggie? Yes, he does.
I love you, Reggie, man. I want to tell you that.
I love you too, Reggie, and your sister, and your family, and everyone around you.
Exactly.
All creeds, religions, and beliefs.
That's right.
They're there for you.
That's right, my brother. Anytime.
All right.
That was good.
All right.
All right. Well, that's the first one.
Peace.